Praise the Lord, you are tuning into the media ministry of Apostle Barbara R. Thomas. This ministry is designed to bring forth revelation and encouragement and to enlighten your minds. Now listen as the woman of God brings you revelation from the Word of God.
Set by and watch the enemy come in and because we're about to talk about Elijah.
Come on.
Elijah. Come on. Oh, God. Hallelujah. We're about to talk about two prophets that made a connection.
Yes.
And in this day and hour, we can hook ups but not connections.
That's right. It's the difference.
And we got to learn how to understand that everybody can plug into the power source.
That's right.
But not everybody has the right wattage.
Yes. All right. Come on, Father.
For the power you carry.
Yes. All right. Oh, my God.
Because if you plug into the wrong outlet, you'll blow it up. Burn it up.
Yes.
Burn it out.
Yes.
Make it in that wall and say, so what is happening in this day and hour is we got people that are plugging into people that cannot handle where they're at.
All right.
And where they're going.
Jesus.
And so when you are dealing with people that don't understand you, the only thing they can do is suppress you.
Yes.
All right.
And hinder you.
Yes.
That's it.
Because they don't have the ability to elevate or push you.
Come on.
And so in this day and hour, what the Lord is doing, because we the people of God, we gotta understand in this day and hour that it's time out for us just connecting to names and gifts.
That's right.
We gotta make sure that we're connecting to the person that has the ability to pull out of what has been deeply embedded in us and buried. Y'all, they say that because we didn't have somebody that knew how to dig out our way.
Jesus, thank you, God.
So the Lord is saying in this hour, it's time out now. Look at somebody and tell them, time out. I ain't got time for it.
Time out. I ain't got time.
And some of us are behind time.
Yeah.
Because we wasted time in the wrong place.
Yeah.
My God.
See, in this day and hour, people are connecting to celebrities.
You're right. You're right about it.
These Christians, you know what I'm talking
about.
These Christian celebrities.
Yes.
You know, the superstars of the church world.
That's right.
All right.
If you ain't got about 10,000 members, they don't want to consider you anything.
Yes.
In the body of Christ.
Yes.
But as I was sitting there, the Lord began to show me something. He said, it is those that they say are not qualified.
My God.
That are going to be the most usable.
Yeah.
All right.
To me in this house.
That's it, right there.
He said, I'm tired of performers.
Jesus.
Because there's no performance of my word operating through me.
Jesus.
If we're going to say that we're called by God, where is the proof of your calling?
Where's the proof?
The Lord began to deal with me about spiritual lineage.
Ah.
Real heavy. He's been dealing with me about that because some of us are traced back to root workers.
All right. All right. It's in your lineage. It's in your lineage.
Homeowners.
All right.
Y'all want to say that right there. Some of y'all looking real deep. Like y'all want to do something.
Come on.
It's traced back to liars.
Yes.
And schemers.
Yes.
That's right.
We trace them back to people that only know how to manipulate.
All right.
Hallelujah. And because you were birthed in that kind of environment, you have somehow picked up their spirit.
Come on.
And even though you don't want to operate that way, because you allow them to lay hands on you and impart it to you, you're carrying the damage of a damaged vessel.
Come on.
And so you're messed up right now because you're connected to the wrong source from the beginning.
My God.
And so when someone comes along to show you truth, you don't have the ability to receive it because you have always seen it done like this.
Come on.
You've always seen your pastor lie and scheme.
Yes, that's right.
You see him make babies.
That's right. Come on.
You've seen them gossip and try to tear down other people's ministry.
Yes. That's right.
You've seen them do designated hour, the Lord is saying, in this hour, I'm getting ready to speak to my servants.
My God.
And they're getting ready to pass the mantle.
My God.
Oh, God. Hallelujah. Look at somebody and tell them the mantles are coming now. Because requires you to walk in a depth of consecration that many people are not willing to walk in. And so we have now in this season a bunch of renegades.
Come on.
They're in the body of Christ that are trying to lead people, that are trying to get to their purpose, but they can't get there because who's leading them don't know where they're going either.
My God. My God.
People that are being shipwrecked on purpose.
On purpose. My God.
Oh, God.
On purpose.
So the Lord began to deal with me about these two prophets right here, because you got to understand, you got to know, and you got to get an understanding. I need a good reader, because you know I'm about to come out from up here. I don't really like being here.
Amen. We read.
I like to be close to the people. That's me. Hallelujah. So I'm going to need somebody that got a good voice. And they gonna be trying to read cute.
Amen.
Amen. Get real dignified. You know what I'm saying? Amen. You can't all get them to say the words out because they trying to impress people.
Amen.
I need somebody gonna read with some authority.
Amen.
And with an understanding that I'm the preacher for the night and not them.
That's right. Amen. We got you. Come on,
Pastor.
Y'all hear me? Hallelujah. Lift your hands and God help Apostle, because he don't know.
God bless him.
Hallelujah. Lift your hands one more time and tell God thank you.
Thank you.
You now feel the weight of God's glory.
Amen.
In this place. I feel the weight of God's glory. And sometimes we are looking for certain things to happen. But how many know that when you just get obedience, the glory of God will just show up.
All right.
You don't even have to try to do anything.
That's right.
For the presence of the Lord to show up when obedience is in the house.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Lift your hand one more time and tell God, thank you.
Thank you.
Because we as a people got to get out of our comfort zone.
That's right.
We have become comfortable with just coming to church, hearing a good sermon, and then going home without anything that would cause us to grow.
Yeah.
Amen.
We have become accustomed to music,
yes,
which have made us become insecure.
Yes. All right.
When there's not musicians in the house.
That's right.
Oh,
that's right.
Oh.
Miss y'all up.
That's right.
Because we have to understand that when the glory of the Lord appears, he don't need any added
music. Amen.
He's able to perform his word without additives to it.
Yeah.
Come on.
And so I told the people at the beginning of this year that in this day and hour, there will be times when your services, when the Lord will not allow the musicians or the singers to show up.
Come on.
And he want to see, do you know how to go into my presence with just your my presence that's in you? See, sometimes we're shitting around and we feel like church is boring and we ain't jumping and shouting.
Come on,
and getting the music and the, looking at me crazy. But how many of us can praise God just because we know he's God?
Hey.
Yeah. and he start moving you in a direction you ain't never went in before.
That's right. That's right.
As long as we can understand it, we're able to comprehend.
Yes.
But when the Lord begins to not give us a prelude.
Yeah.
Of what he's about to do. Yeah.
All right.
I think that can you still follow him.
Yeah,
when he takes and blind your eyes when you can't read that paper.
My God. Oh, my God.
Lord God. Hallelujah. Yeah. Lift your hand and say, God, help me to follow the right person.
Help me to follow the right person.
See, you got a lot of people now that got the cloud with them.
All right.
We don't have too many people. We don't have artificial clouds and everything.
Yeah.
Because you know, in this day and hour, they make their own
stuff. That's right. Oh. They got smoke machines.
They got the smoke machines, and then they got the psychedelic lights because they're trying to get y'all high in the spirit.
Yeah.
And what they're doing is recreating an era. But the people were drawn and pulled into drugs.
That's
and
right.
Y'all look at that.
That's right.
You got to understand the devil is subtle and he's very swift.
Yes.
And he's able to get you into a mindset.
Yes.
I told you, I don't need to remember those days when I was selling drugs because the money was
right.
Good.
That's right.
Hey. The devil been no made me think when there be leaving time. Some of the saints are running around singing right now. Let's do it again. Let's do it again.
All right now.
And they're all doing it again. And that's why we have so much of the world now coming into church. Get over here on God's time and then let me just go ahead and preach.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Look at somebody and tell them, I don't know about you.
I don't know about you.
But I'm about to pursue somebody.
I'm about to pursue somebody.
Hello.
You
going to
read?
I'm
doing. Amen. Amen. Verse 19. So he departed thence and found Elijah the son of Shaphat, who was plowing with 12 yoke of oxen before him, and he with the 12. And Elijah passed over unto him and cast his mantle upon him.
Come on.
And he left the oxen and ran after Elijah.
Come.
And said, let me, I pray thee, kiss my father and my mother, and then I will follow thee. Mm-hmm. And he said unto him, go back again, for what have I done to thee?
Come on.
Verse 21, and he returned from following him, and took the yoke of oxen, and slew them, and boiled their flesh with the instruments of the oxen, and gave unto the people, and they did eat. Then he arose and went after Elijah, and ministered unto him.
Look at somebody and tell them, I don't know about you.
I don't know about you.
But I got to get rid of what's behind me.
I got to get rid of what's behind me.
To get what's before me.
And get what's before me.
Look at somebody else and tell them, I got to get rid of what's behind me.
I
got
to get rid of what's behind me.
To get what's before me. Come on, lift your hands, Father, we thank you for your word in Jesus. Hallelujah. Here we have a perfect example of what he's saying in this day and hour for those of you that the Lord is getting ready to push you.
Yes.
Because the Spirit of the Lord began to tell me, he said, many of the people are hesitant about accepting their calling because they have seen so much wickedness.
All right.
Connected to what I have called them to do.
All right.
And because they don't want to be put in the arena with what is being said about the call, they are rejecting what God has given them and taking a lesser seat and a lesser call so that they won't get the warfare when they have to go against what man has positioned and has been an error in the body of Christ.
My God.
Now, what you got to understand that in this day and hour, we have to get to a point that we understand when God is placing someone in our life that's going to help us to get to where we need to go.
Yes.
We've got to get beyond what we have been taught to be as the right way for something to be done.
Come on.
Because man have taught us in error the things concerning the pursuit of knowledge.
Yes.
We have now taken on a form of thinking that preachers owe us something.
Yes.
Come on.
Yes.
Oh, y'all ain't
saying that. My God.
And we have begun to disrespect the anointing of a man and woman of God's life because we have seen wickedness through the call. And so now in this day and hour, the Lord is getting ready to bring the honor back to men and women of God. Why is he doing that? Because, the people cannot receive what the Lord is saying as long as they have those before them that are saying the wrong thing.
All right.
We got to get beyond talking about we going to preach and we can still do what we want to do.
All right.
Hallelujah. This is the day and the hour right now where you got to get an understanding that your calling is going to cost you something.
It's
going to cost you something.
Yes.
God began to show me, he said, the reason why they devalue what I have given them and they're willing to sell out to the enemy is because they don't respect it for one thing. He said, then they don't reverence me.
Yeah.
He said, they gotta understand, oh my God, that promotion comes from me. Hallelujah. And when I promote them into a position, it's because I see in them what the devil said will never come off.
Hallelujah.
He said, and then when they get over here and begin to walk in the ways of the Lord, they begin to listen to other voices that give them shortcuts. They
Jesus.
Hallelujah. But look at somebody and tell them my anointing can't be brought.
Come on.
And tell them it can't be put on layaway either.
That's
remember?
Yeah.
Well, he was stuck off in a cave that he wasn't supposed to be in.
Yeah. Mm.
He done ran from Jezebel. Look at somebody and tell him, stop running from them bales. Hallelujah. You got to learn how to stand and face the opposition that opposes what the Lord has given you to do.
That's right.
We got people that have left their place. Mm.
Come on with it.
Because they couldn't take the opposition of the city.
That's it.
Let me tell you something. Just because you are being opposed don't mean that God didn't send you there.
Come on.
You
got
to say that again about this.
Come on.
Because sometimes your deepest well is in the hardest places to know.
Yes, sir.
Because we as a people have learned how to have everything because the preachers have told us we can sow a seed and it's going to be all right.
Go ahead.
We can lay hands on you and it's going to be all right.
Glory.
But sometimes you can sow a seed, you can lay hand, and it boil you down, and everything else, and it's still not going to move until God said it's time.
That's right.
And so here he was, he done ran into a cave, and in the midst of the cave, the Lord begins to talk to him.
Right.
Now this is just me getting this revelation right
here.
But I got a revelation because when he came out of the cave,
uh-huh.
God begins to tell him, go find your successor.
Yes.
All right.
Go get it.
Because I see right now it's going to be a problem with you.
Yes.
Because you don't just kill all these false prophets.
Come on.
And then get saved.
Then you hear one little voice. And you run to a cave from your assignment.
Yes. Stop running from your assignment.
Wow.
And right after he's in this cave, the Lord gives him a commission.
Yes.
To go and get your successor.
Yes.
Uh-oh.
Yes.
Uh-oh. Yes. Uh-oh. It's about to be a mass murder. Because what a whole lot of preachers don't understand right now is God is getting ready to make them put their mantle on somebody else. Because when he called them to do the job, they went through it. He told them to go to a certain region, they didn't go. So now he's getting ready to anoint somebody to take over what they was supposed to be for when the plane would go to. He's getting ready to take over some churches right now. Hallelujah. Because he gave a mandate to the preacher and told him, I want you to open the house of God. And this is the way I wanted God. And this is the way. But they became afraid of the people in the city because what they were called to do was different than what everybody else was called to do. And they didn't want to make no way. So instead of them changing their environment, they became like the environment. Y'all ain't want to say it.
Jesus.
And he understood because of some disobedience.
Yes, yes.
But he had, God had told him to run in no cave.
That's right.
He ran from one woman.
One woman. Jesus.
Amen.
My God.
One woman.
One woman.
That might be why
we're being
afraid of.
I think it is. I think it is.
It can
be there.
One woman
can
be a dead.
Yes, God.
And she's the wrong woman. Yes, Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
That might be why there's a little problem in the body of Christ.
Because
one woman can either bring the kingdom, oh my God,
down
to a place in God or take the whole kingdom.
Yes.
Down. And right now, in this day and hour, we got a whole lot of Jezebel and women trying to walk as devils.
That's right. That's right. Stay in your lane.
Y'all ain't saying that right there. We got a whole lot of Jezebel and women trying to walk as devils in this hour.
That's right.
And they're causing the women, hallelujah, to get out of place. They're causing the men to be afraid to be placed with them.
That's right. That's right.
Amen.
It's the truth.
Look at somebody and tell them you just got to know what to do.
Got to know what to do.
So here he is. Got in here. Have this showdown. Come on now. Showdown at the mountain. Come on. And then he gets over here and gets scared. And then right after that, the Lord begins to tell him that you've been to go and cast your net.
Yes.
On your replacement.
Yes. My God.
Hallelujah. Now, it was some years before it happened.
Yes.
But it still had to happen.
Yes.
Amen.
Y'all looking at me strong.
Mm-hmm. All right.
I ain't saying you're going to die today.
Yeah.
But eventually, you're going to have to get a body.
Surely.
Come on.
Amen.
Come on.
Amen. Glory.
And when you go, what is the vision going to do?
That's right.
Is the vision going to go in the grave with you?
That's right.
Or have you trained somebody to get
the vision
gone?
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen. Amen.
Oh,
my God. Yes.
So he departs and he finds him. And he was plowing.
Uh-huh.
With a governmental anointing.
Yes.
Because he had 12 ox.
He had ox. Yes, sir. The apostolic ox.
Y'all don't even understand what he was setting all that up.
Yes.
Y'all do know the ox stand for that apostolic too.
Yes.
Now, the ox had the eagles.
No, the ox.
Y'all just want to be eagles, but really eagles are really connected to the prophetic.
Yes. Hmm. Yes. Yes.
Oh, well, that's the apostles.
That's all right. Hallelujah. Yes.
I messed them up because they thought they were the eagle.
Yes.
When they talk about the eagle.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Common sense will let you know that would be somebody that
can
see.
Yes. That's right. That's right. That's right.
So the eagle is really connected to the prophet.
Yeah.
And the ox to the ox. Okay. Y'all got it now.
That's it.
Yeah. Look at somebody and tell you're going to have to get some ox.
Yeah.
We need some ox. We need some ox.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Because an ox, when you use it, it takes you to a deep. They have a deeper and more effective way of plowing.
Yes, they do.
Yeah.
Yes, they do. Yes, they
and
do.
So, if you're going to say you are apostle in this hour, then you cannot come with a mediocre revelation.
Come on.
That's right, apostle.
Your understanding of things is a lot deeper and more effective.
Yes.
Oh, because you're not saying, oh God, this
Lord.
You're not saying what will cause the people, oh God, to jump and shout.
Yes.
But when you get an apostle in the midst, a true apostle, a true apostle doesn't come to dance and shout you.
That's right.
They come to sit you down so you can learn.
That's right.
Yeah.
Giving out the word. Come on now. They don't need you falling out talking about you in the spirit. Get out. Come on now. So you can finish hearing what the revelation of what God is saying. Because they want you to be effective when you leave out the door. Look, I don't care. of what I need.
Yes.
Woo.
Amen.
Look at somebody and tell them you need somebody. Ooh, wait, I hear you. I'm telling that to you. He said, tell the people of God it's time for a shift change.
All right.
It's time for somebody else to come to work.
Come on.
Right. Oh, God. It's time for somebody else to take over now.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a shift change going on right now. Y'all looking at me crazy. Hallelujah. We're changing shifts.
Yeah.
It's a shift
change.
Now it's a shift change.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. For those of you that know what it means to have a job, you know
it's a shift change.
Some folks looking at me like,
yes.
I know you ain't never worked. If you don't want to shift change, it's what you
God.
Need that somebody else come on to.
Yeah.
And so the Lord said in this hour, he's doing a shift change right now.
Yeah.
So you got to move out the way because somebody else got to come on duty now.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Lift your hand and say, God, help me not to stand in the way of your progress.
Yeah.
And so you can't get intimidated because everybody has a time and season.
Yes.
Responsibility than I am.
Yes.
Because look where God
Yes.
He has you with the governmental authority.
That's right.
Of an apostle.
Yes.
That had not been named
yes.
in the earth yet.
That's right. Come on. That's right. That's right.
Oh.
Yes.
You got to understand that the Old Testament is a pattern of the New Testament.
That's right.
The New Testament is a pattern of the Old
that's
Testament.
Right.
That's right.
So everything that's happened in the New was in the Old.
No.
But you had to have the understanding of the mystery.
That's right.
Of the Word of God to understand that what was being said in the Old was what was manifested in the New.
Yes.
And that they took and used modern terms.
Right. That's it.
For modern people.
That's
and
it.
What people don't understand is the language changes.
That's right.
According to the people.
That's
understanding.
That's right. That's right.
Glory.
Oh.
Amen.
That's why Paul said, I gotta become all things.
All
things.
And he had to learn how they talk.
That's
he
right.
had to learn their culture.
That's right.
How to do in order
that's
to win them.
Right.
He didn't become them.
Timing for them to be stirred up.
Yes.
Thank you, God.
Oh, I'm just gonna mess up.
Glory.
yeah.
Hallelujah. And so here it is. Hallelujah. And it's an injustice, leaders, if the people come to you for the wisdom and knowledge and you withhold it from them.
Amen.
When the Lord has connected you to them.
That's right. That's right.
Thomas, you just gonna give a little bit because you don't want nobody to know as much as you. Jesus. Sometimes they know more than you.
Sometimes.
But you have the wisdom and the knowledge. As the experience, so they want to make some kind of mistake.
That's now, right. That's right. That's right.
Hallelujah. Give me help and say, God, help me to stay humble.
God, help me to stay humble.
While my teaching is with me.
While my teaching is with me.
Hallelujah. The one thing the Lord been dealing with me about, Pastor, he's been talking to me, and every time I'm in prayer, and every time, and I say, God, what do you want me to do? You know the word he gives me? Mm. Rabbi.
Yes, teacher.
He said, I just want you to be a rabbi.
Teacher.
A scholar.
Yes.
Not only in my work.
Yes.
But in a relationship with me. So in revelation and mysteries. Yes. Because you got to understand, they go in to get the mysteries of the word.
All right.
Oh, God.
Glory.
They got an understanding that supersedes just someone having knowledge.
Yes.
Book knowledge.
Glory.
History knowledge.
Yes.
Oh, God. Glory. Hallelujah. And then they had to have a relationship with God. Well, they can talk to him. You know what? I can give it to your God. I said, I want a relationship like you had with Moses. You said you talked to him face to face.
Yes, he did.
Without any interference from other people.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? That's why Aaron and Mary got in trouble.
That's right.
And that's the first thing he said to him. He said, didn't you know I talked to him first to face to face? Y'all lost your mind. You didn't even understand the relationship I had with Moses.
Yes.
That's why when people running around here touching God's anointing,
That's right.
They don't even know what kind of relationship those people have. And nowadays, everybody's talking about, well, I'm anointed too. You anointed, but you ain't got no sense.
That's right.
It didn't make a difference. Come on, man. You anointed, yeah. You like to prophesy and call everybody's name. But it ain't going to do you no good to call their name and you can't take them where they need to go.
That's right.
You calling that man for entertainment. Come on, man. When God called that man, he called him for service.
Yes.
Jesus. Not just run around here calling people names.
Glory.
When he got ready to call your name, it's because he's ready for you to do something.
That's right.
Or don't do it.
Hallelujah.
Oh, God.
Glory.
Hallelujah. So here he was, and then he begins this. And the Bible said, he didn't even acknowledge him. The Bible just said he walks by him and casts his mouth. See, what you need to understand, the very person that might have what you need, you don't even know.
Jesus, come on here.
You trying to pick somebody that you don't know for 10, 20 years.
Yeah.
All right.
But the person that might have what you need,
Jesus.
Oh God, is only a person.
Jesus.
That you don't even know. Not and when the time is right, God will begin to reveal them to you.
Yes.
Oh God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. He's out there doing his oxen. He's out there plowing like he usually do. Here comes this prophet out of nowhere.
Yes.
And throws his mantle on him.
Yes.
My God. Now you know something is really going on. You out in the field and this man just shows up.
Yes.
He just shows up and then gives you his mantle, and everybody at that time understood a mantle.
It means,
what it really meant.
Yes.
He knew that he wasn't just giving him something.
Yes.
This wasn't no little present, you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
This ain't like we do with the prayer shawls, trying to put them on and make ourselves seem deep.
Yeah, that's right.
We got prayer shawls, people wearing prayer shawls. Don't even know what they even represent.
Jesus.
Oh God. And they just put them on just to, this wasn't that kind of thing where you just put it on because you want people to thank you deep.
Yes.
Hallelujah. There was an understanding behind that.
Yes.
Hallelujah. He understood. Wait a minute. He don't put his mantle on me. He don't chose me.
Yeah.
This is not just any old thing.
Yes.
This is a high honor.
Jesus.
Because this is the prophet of the nation.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Which means that what he's given me,
Jesus,
is going to tell them what I already got.
Jesus, my God.
So if he's just a prophet to this nation, what is God telling me I'm going to be a prophet to? what you don't understand.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Lift your hand and say, God, help me to know whose mantle I got. Help me to know whose mantle I got. See, we don't let so many people just put their hands on us.
Yes.
And it was not for everybody to lay their hands on you.
Say
it again.
Come on here.
Say it again.
The church have told us that.
Yes.
That you're just supposed to go around with everybody.
Jesus. Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus.
You in everybody's prayer line.
Yes.
Trying to get that impartation.
That's right. That's right.
That's why your mind all twisted.
Ain't it?
Your spirit all jacked up.
My God.
You're going through all kinds of trouble. Look like some of them laid their hands on you and a curse start coming.
All right.
Now look at that bitch crying. Hallelujah. Because that was not supposed to be the mantle you catch.
That's right. That's exactly right.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Your mantle
set us free.
When he understood, when he put the mantle, he felt the weight.
Yes. My God.
Elijah's mantle.
Yes.
He felt the weight of the presence of Elijah.
Yes.
He knew who he was supposed to connect to.
Yeah.
Because he felt the weight of his presence.
Glory. Amen. My God.
Amen.
If you can't feel the weight of the presence of your leader,
my God,
is something wrong.
Something is wrong.
Seriously.
Yes.
How are you in an intimate? Because be they mental, spiritual cover.
Yeah.
Pastor only.
That's right.
You were supposed to have enough intimacy.
That's right.
In the spirit.
Yes. Pick them up.
Till if they sleep, you say, gosh, you.
Come on. Come on here. Yes.
You were supposed to be able to pick up
their
mantle. Yes. You gotta understand. Which what he's saying is you're picking up the spirit.
Yes.
Of the calling.
Yes.
That is connected
to
your calling.
That's right.
Oh, God.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Look at somebody and ask him, have you picked up the right thing?
Hallelujah.
You just run around here just picking up stuff. Then I pick up in the spirit. That's how she asked her to project herself to you.
That's right. That's right. You witch. Ain't that the truth?
Come on. You weren't supposed to get that.
Mm-mm.
Come on now.
Mm-mm.
Come on.
That's right. That's right.
He didn't have to show up in Liza's dreams.
That's right. That's right. Come on, teach us.
Lay your hands on.
That's right.
Come on. And then you got to watch these people that run around. You know, because some of them, you know, trying to summon your spirit.
That's right.
You're right. Oh,
y'all right. You're right. Yes. Come on.
If you're not careful, you'll find yourself drawn to people.
That's right.
That you weren't supposed to be drawn to.
That's right. That's right. That's right. Spiritual summoning.
Don't look at me saying.
You're right.
You found yourself as a leader drawn to people.
Yes.
That you weren't supposed to be drawn to.
That's right.
Because they begin to try to pull your spirit toward
you. That's right. That's right.
It's an illegal connection.
Yes. Illegal. My God.
And you'll find out after a while it's illegal when they get finished giving you all that.
Yes.
You get finished going.
Yeah.
Your kid is going through that person. Trying to find out if you're dealing with somebody with about 15 personalities.
Yeah.
All right.
My God.
Some of these people are pulling you toward this.
Yes.
Oh, Lord.
My God. You're right.
Come on. Hallelujah. Some lady was trying to say something to me. I said, let me tell you something, baby. I don't even know you.
That's right.
Oh, I'm on your Facebook page. I said, hey.
Okay.
I want to talk to you.
That's right.
So why would you be interesting to me?
That's right.
I said, that's the enemy or even you.
That's right.
Jesus.
Trying to pull me towards you.
That's right.
Jesus.
Because I ain't got no business trying to show up in your dream.
That's right.
Through leader.
That's right.
Come on. Now, I know God can show you people in the dream.
Yes,
I know that for a fact. But don't be trying to pull me in here trying to make it seem like I came to you. You are alive and true that in you. I don't like you, but I'm trying to
trouble. He stayed in his position. Even though he was getting annoyed while he was walking with Elijah, he was still known as the prophet that just poured water on his head because he never tried to make himself visible before time.
That's right. That's right.
I mess y'all up for me. Look at somebody and tell them, just stay hidden until God shows you. People want to be all embarrassed and stuff because they want a light, a spotlight.
That's right.
Come on, come on.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Jesus.
Oh my God. Oh my. Oh my.
The way I know you called to the position for real is when you're not looking for any recognition and don't want to be recognized. Don't even sometimes want your name called. Nobody knew that I even worked with my leader until I would get up when he got on the floor.
Jesus.
Other than that, they didn't even know. Sometimes I didn't even walk in with him.
Yes.
I was in there before him.
Yes, that's right.
Because I had to be a silent killer.
That's right. That's right.
Yeah. When you look, that's what I'm talking about. Yeah. You run around here, want everybody to know. I'm not bad.
Yeah.
Want everybody to know who you are? You got the wrong attitude.
That's yes, right.
Come on now. Because the armor bearer stay hit.
You see?
Yeah.
That's until it. It's time to fight.
That's it.
With the leader.
That's it.
Yes.
You'll never know who they are.
Yeah.
Until the fight is on.
That's right.
Then sometimes you won't know them then.
Yes.
Because remember, Jonathan's armor bearer didn't go before him, he stayed behind.
That's right. Mm-hmm. That's right.
The best position for an armor bearer is behind.
That's right. That's right.
Behind your leader. I told somebody because they were like, well, you can't, I'm your armor bearer, you can't do that. I said,
next. Amen. Next.
I was carrying my armor before you got here.
That's right.
Yes.
That's right.
Yes.
That's right.
I was putting my weapons together
yes.
before you
got
here.
Before you ever showed up.
Amen.
I know how to shoot when I need to shoot.
Yes.
And cut when I need to cut.
Yes.
Come
yes.
on.
Come on. Yes, my God.
That is what you're here for.
Exactly. Hallelujah. Come on, Pastor.
And so really in this day and hour, we don't really have true armor bearers.
Yes. Yeah.
Amen.
Because nobody wants to carry the fight.
Amen.
Amen.
Nobody
Amen.
Wants to fight.
They don't want to carry the weight.
Yes.
And they're not willing to be in position, which is behind.
Yes.
Making sure that nothing attacks
Jesus.
From behind.
Because
God got the rest.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yes.
That's right.
When you have an armor bearer, you let it hang. I just need you to bring my armor to the fight.
Yes.
That's all. Bring my
Amen.
Weapon.
Amen.
That's it.
Bring my weapon.
Yes. Hava. Glory.
Then
come on.
Then he catch me. Bring
right.
my weapon.
Bring my weapon.
You carry my weapon.
Yes.
Not yours.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Glory be to God. Mama, you deep, Apostle.
Right there.
So he runs after Elijah. Look at somebody and tell them, ask them one more time, who you running after?
Who you running after?
He said, let me, I pray, to kiss my father and my mother, and then I will follow thee. And he got a little sarcastic and said, go back again, for what have I done to thee?
Yeah.
In other words, it ain't my call.
Yes. Mm.
I only obey God.
That's right.
So whether you come or don't come,
that's right.
It ain't gonna make me no never. Cause I did what God told me to do.
That's right.
And see, this is the problem with leadership in this hour. Oh God, you sitting up there worried about whether they're gonna follow you when you don't already instructed them and told them what God said.
That's right.
Amen. Either they coming or they ain't coming.
That's right.
Amen. Wow.
No, without a shadow of doubt, if they don't take the position, it won't be vacant.
You gonna make me run.
Yes.
I'm about to run.
Because he's gonna bring somebody to the
yes.
field.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
My God.
He's not gonna never leave us with a breach.
My
yes.
God.
Come on back. He's not gonna never leave us unarmed.
My God.
No, let me start. He's not gonna leave us unarmed.
Yes.
And anytime he brings you to a leadership, it's for the sheep. Anytime he brings you to a leadership, he is saying that there is something I need you to plug up.
All right.
In their vision.
Yes.
It ain't for you to come and start your own vision inside their vision.
Amen.
Jesus.
It's for you to come learn and then get out.
All right.
Thank you, God.
That's it.
Because we have a tendency to want to stay in somebody else's nest.
Yes.
and started to hatch stuff in their nest.
Mm. Amen.
Come on.
All right.
So you look at somebody and tell me, ain't but one needle in this nest.
Ain't
but one needle in this nest. But you don't understand, God. Another eagle will attack another eagle.
Oh, yes, they will. Yeah. They will.
They'll do it.
Amen.
Oh, look at somebody and tell them it's time now.
It's
time. So Pastor tell him, I don't have nothing to do with this. God told me to anoint you. And yeah. Right here told me to put my mantle on you. Told me to, oh my God, to let you understand that you are the one that's supposed to succeed.
Jesus.
But if you don't want to take the job, don't get it twisted.
Yes.
Just
yes.
Ain't gonna stay back here for long.
He won't stop. Hallelujah.
Because the will of the Lord still will be done.
Yes.
Hallelujah. But it's just strange. Hallelujah. Because we don't want to start off in a circuit.
My God,
I got to serve. If you don't know how to serve, you don't know how to lead. Come on now. Come on. Because this is where you are. That's how you are through serving. Come on now. Because you always will remain a servant.
Yeah.
Even when you're leading, you're still a servant.
Yeah.
So when you get to the point that you don't want to serve, it's time for you to move out the way so somebody else that wants to serve can have the position.
Yeah.
Jesus, I give you praise.
Yeah. So he returns back from you. And what he was doing was he was closing the door to everything familiar to him.
Yes.
That's why he needed to go back.
Yes.
He needed to go back so he can let them know that God has shifted me.
That's right. Yes. That's right. Hallelujah. Yeah.
What I was doing, I'm not doing
it. I can't do it no more.
And even though y'all got all this money and property,
come on.
I gotta give all this up.
Yes.
You better speak.
That's it.
To follow my purpose.
I got to follow.
Yes.
Thank you, God.
The reason why some people don't want to follow you is because they feel like you too little.
Yeah.
For them.
They want a big name. My God. Jesus.
As well.
Instead of you asking how many members they got.
Yes. Mm. Jesus.
You need to be asking how many people got to their purpose through you.
That's right.
All right.
Amen. How many people they get to
that? That's
Jesus.
How many people you get to destiny and the Lord for them in your ministry?
Amen. My God.
So if you got still got 30,000 people sitting up in there.
Jesus.
And somebody got moved.
Glory.
Somebody's still in a position that they should have vacated.
Yes.
So he had to go back and close the door to what was familiar to him.
Jesus.
And to disconnect from what was familiar to him.
Yes.
He had to let his parents go, I love you, but when it comes to the spirit, I got to leave you.
Yes.
You still my parents, I still love you, it ain't got nothing to do with that. I just got to go a little bit further because what I need, he got.
Jesus.
I'm not going to never be what God called me to be as long as I'm up under your roof.
Yeah, that's right. Woo. Glory. My God.
That's right.
My God.
That's right.
I'm about to mess up the church money.
Come on. Stand up.
Look at somebody and tell them. We're about to move in our position now.
You got to move in
our position. The Bible said, then he went back and he closed the door to his past.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Because he recognized the fact I never get to where the Lord wants me to go as long as I have this past still standing open. See, when the Lord begins to shift you, this will help some of you. You got to disconnect from that leader that held you in bondage. Why are you still trying to hold on to Pharaoh when Moses is trying to take you into the promised land?
My God. Jesus.
You still holding on to that old leader. Oh, like you got to try to prove a point. You prove a point when you left them. They said,
Uh-huh.
Or the mentor that have ministered to you.
All right. Mm.
That's your tribe right there.
That's it. That's it.
It's not the people that come to be ministered to.
Uh-huh.
Who's coming to minister to you?
There you go. Who ought to serve you?
Oh, I'm a messer.
Oh, my.
I'm a messer. Please come out and tell me I want to know what you come here for.
Yeah.
Amen. What you got to start answering people when they show up, what you coming for?
Amen. That's right. That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
I need to know.
What you here for?
Yeah.
Why did God connect you to me?
Yes. Glory.
He went so he could minister unto him.
Yes.
He wanted to serve him.
Yes.
Not him serve him.
Yes.
Right.
For some reason, they have reversed that role.
Yes.
In this modern day church. Yes.
Uh-huh.
Well, they're looking for the leaders to just serve them.
Yes.
And they never minister to the leaders.
All right.
That's right.
I was telling the people of God, you know, I don't like appreciation. The reason why I like appreciation is because you get pain.
So that's right. That's right.
Because very people that you have ministered to
are
the very ones that won't even minister to you.
Come on, right. Come on. They won't give back.
But the Lord told me to let them do this one this year.
Amen.
I'm gonna see how it's gonna come out.
All right.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
I'm serious.
Yeah.
And that's the reason why I didn't like them.
Yeah.
Because then I got to look at you now.
Yeah.
And you still might still be my assignment.
That's right.
But I know that you don't love me.
You don't appreciate me.
That's it.
Amen.
Oh,
don't
let me
come on here.
From Matthew 19, I'm making a list, checking it twice.
That's right.
But I found out folks ain't with you.
That's right.
Like they say, you can sow into them and they won't sow back into you.
That's right. That's right. That's the truth.
You've been no soul $400 or $500 in that ministry.
Jesus.
Then you can go to the restaurant with them and they won't even pay for your $7 meal.
My God. So sad. Jesus. My God.
But that's your leader.
That's right.
Now when they come, I ask them, will you die for me?
That's it. That's it. Okay? Yeah.
And that's what all of theirs do.
That's what they do.
Yeah. You know that. That's you what
they
do.
That's it.
Look at y'all, already quit your job now. Intercessors, you're supposed to be the one taking direct hits.
That's right.
So your leader won't take them. That's look right. at somebody and tell them, I got to find my connection tonight.
I got to find my connection tonight.
Some of you don't even recognize you behind time because you connected with the wrong person from the beginning.
Jesus.
It's very important in this day and hour that you seek God. As to who he's calling you to walk with and let me tell you something.
You can't look at whether they have 50,000 members.
That's right. That's right.
Because the wealth of knowledge.
That's right.
Wisdom and understanding and revelation some of these leaders have.
Yes.
Put some of these big time preachers
to shame.
Yes. I know leaders.
Yes.
These are people with no name. They ain't even trying to claim nothing.
Yes.
They don't even want you to call their name. They don't got a title. They don't want a title.
Jesus.
But they got revelation
that'll
blow people's mind.
Yes. Come on. I got it.
We got people that don't have a name. Ain't trying to get a title.
Yes.
See, when people come in, they looking for a position. Yes. They ain't ready for you.
That's right.
Your first thought when you connect with a leader is, where you going to put me in the ministry? Mm-hmm. Then you there for the wrong reason.
Exactly. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Your first word should be, how can I serve you?
That's right.
That's it.
What do you need to be
there?
There
you go. Amen. That's it.
Amen. Thank you, God.
That's it.
As leaders, you got to start asking people, why did God send you?
That's right.
And what can you give this ministry that we don't already have?
That's it. Make them accountable. Yes.
And in this day and hour, accountability is zero.
All right. Isn't it?
Maybe about 5%. Let me not say zero. About
5%. Yeah.
That really are accountable to their leaders.
That's right. That's right. You're right.
Come on.
You're right. You're right.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
How did they know he was the prophet that washed his hands?
Uh-huh.
Every time they saw him.
Yeah.
They saw him.
Yes.
Sir.
That's right.
Not preaching.
That's right.
Not praying.
That's right.
Not prophesying.
Yes.
Not leading to serve.
Serving.
He was serving.
That's right.
Look at somebody and ask him, who let you serve?
Who had for
the anointing on your life?
For the anointing on your life.
Jesus.
It makes you think about who have you served? Who were your spiritual lineage?
Yes.
Who can I call today that can vouch for you?
Yes.
See, they won't tell you they're old either because they know they messed up with them.
Yes.
Let me try to tell you about somebody 20 years ago when you was just with this one last week.
That's right. That's right.
You trying to get a good report. I want to know the real report.
Yes. That's right.
What happened? Because sometimes people lead, they're leading because they did something wrong. Not so much that the leader did something to them. Come on.
All right.
All these leaders have been bad.
That's right.
You don't have 15 leaders in 1 year.
Oh, my Jesus. God.
Something I know some people you. Like that.
Something wrong.
It ain't the leader.
Yeah.
15 people.
Yeah.
Somebody should have been able to get along with you.
That's right.
Come on.
That's right.
Then you have to say, God, help me find the right people.
God, help me find the right people.
Spirit of the Lord said this day and hour, he's calling you. He wants you. You got to answer the call.
Yes.
He answered the call. Come on. Hallelujah.
Yes.
He understood. My God, when the mantle was thrown on him, he picked up Elijah instantly.
Yes.
And began to want to be with him.
Yes.
But he knew in order for him to be effective with Elijah, he had to cut some strings from the past.
Yes.
He had to cut away some stuff.
Yes.
Don't come to the new leadership trying to bring your old leader with you.
Yes, that's right.
Trying to clone them through the new.
My God.
You know, my old pastor did like that. I said, well, you know what? You need to be with your old pastor.
That's right. That's right.
Because I'm me.
And
come
I'm
on. Hallelujah. Look at somebody and tell them, let nobody take your leading over somebody. Come on now. I told one person, I said, well, that was your pastor, not your lover.
Okay. Jesus.
You out there? Oh, wait. Maybe not.
Maybe not. All right.
Because you ought to be able to lead somebody.
Yeah.
For your destiny.
That's right.
Yes. It don't mean that you even fell out. This is what even leaders need to understand. Yes. Sometimes you have given them all they can get from you.
Yes.
You got to know how to allow them to go forth and get what they need. But now you take a curse them and put them in hell and turn their momentum and curse their finances, their ministry, and their life, their children, their children's children. You just go behind them throwing out a person.
Jesus, my God.
So the things are getting ready to say. Somebody lift their hand and praise the Lord for that. Because you've been waiting for a long time. You've been waiting for a long time.
woman.
That's right.
I think you look better with somebody else.
That's right.
It's evident by the way things are going with
That's
our
right.
relationship.
That's right.
That you ain't supposed to leave with me.
Not here. Man. That's right.
So, I free you.
In Jesus' name.
And ain't no hard feelings.
That's right.
Love you.
That's right.
Love you.
Love you by.
Mean it.
Uh-huh.
You don't want you here.
That's right. Time to go.
Come on. Sometimes you just got to tell them.
That's right.
And it will free you and them.
That's right.
Amen.
Because as long as you don't
say it. That's right.
They're going to stay right there.
That's right. That's right.
But when you let them know, I know that I'm not the one for you.
Yes. That's right.
Yes. That you need to find your leader.
That's right. Amen. That's right.
Find your voice.
That's right.
Find who you can respect.
That's right.
Because it's evident from our relationship.
Yes.
If you don't respect me,
amen.
And if you can't respect your leader,
that's right.
You can't gain nothing from it.
That's right. That's right.
Yeah, you're right.
Look at somebody and ask about the street with your leader.
Are you sure you with your leader?
Because it ought to be some kind of respect.
Yes.
You're right.
Hallelujah.
I know a thing I'm not telling nobody what it is, but I exactly know who really this is supposed to be.
That's right.
Amen. I have a little thing God gave me.
Yes.
Five keys.
Yes.
To know when you'll shoot.
Ah, my God.
Yes. I don't teach that hopefully, but I'm going to teach that to somebody else.
Yes.
Amen.
Five keys. Know you'll shoot exactly who they are.
Amen.
Key things
to
look for.
Amen.
To know you'll shoot.
Wow.
Amen.
And if somebody had asked me, are you sure?
Are you sure?
You're with who you're supposed to be.
You're with who you're supposed to be.
Because if you don't respect
them,
that's right.
You know.
You don't honor them.
Yes.
You can't be honorable and submissive to
the
leadership.
Yeah.
You don't need to be with them.
Yeah. That's right.
This year, when he got the medal, he immediately went into servanthood, not ministry.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Tell so many people, listen, God told me you come. Told me you're gonna be the successor.
Yes.
Take an insurance policy.
Amen.
You're right.
Hallelujah. Count you out.
And then you trying to kill.
Yes.
From day one.
Yes.
Amen.
But when you wait on your time,
that's it. My God.
The anointing that comes.
My God.
Even when it came time for Elijah to leave him, he still wouldn't let nobody talk about his leader.
Yes. Hallelujah.
When you can sit around and let somebody talk about your leader,
that ain't your leader. That ain't your leader. That's it.
Man.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's it.
That's true.
Amen.
That's it. You're right.
That's it.
Look at somebody and ask them, who been talking to you lately?
Who been talking to you lately?
And who y'all been talking about?
That's it. That's it. That's it. Hallelujah.
You don't let nobody sit around
right.
and discuss your leader.
That's right.
That's right.
Amen.
I don't care if you get into a disagreement.
Yes.
A disagreement does not forfeit your assignment.
That's right. That's right.
You gotta get enough maturity to know how to have a disagreement but still be workable.
That's right.
With your assignment.
That's right.
Uh-oh.
That's it.
Uh-oh.
That's it.
Look at somebody and tell them, All I want to know is are you ready?
Is are you ready?
For God's assignment for your life.
Assignment for your life.
Come on, lift your hands and tell God thank you.
Thank you, God.
Come on, tell God
thank you. Thank you, God.
Come on,
thank you, God.
Come on,
thank you, God.
Because
thank you, God.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The Spirit of the Lord said,
my God.
He's getting ready to change some directions in this hour. I was looking at feet just then, and feet, well, you know how somebody put on the wrong shoe and it's pointed in
the wrong way,
and that's what I kept seeing, feet that were pointed in the wrong way,
because
they got on the shoes on the wrong feet.
That's right. That's right.
And the Lord said there are some people now that he has to correct their feet.
Yes.
Thank
you,
God. Thank you, God.
Because their feet are going the wrong way.
Yes.
The direction that you have been sent was sabotaged by the enemy.
Jesus.
Because Satan knew that you wasn't equipped for the warfare. Ooh. He was getting ready to send you into.
Jesus.
But because we're so status minded,
yes,
we'll let somebody call us an apostle,
yes,
when we know we're a prophet.
That's it. That's it. For the glory. Yes.
We'll let somebody call us a prophet.
Yes.
When we know we're a janitor.
That's it. Jesus.
And so the Lord said in this season, he got a correct assignment.
Yes.
Look at somebody and tell them the assignment is about to be corrected.
The assignment is about to be corrected.
So that you won't be overthrown by the warfare.
Yes.
Come on, lift your hands and tell God, thank you.
Thank you, God.
Because he could have let us continue on walking in a way. Come on now. He could have let us continue on walking different.
Yes.
Come on.
Jesus.
Out of his will. And get us at the last minute when we stand before him and say, I don't know you because that ain't what I signed you to do.
That's right.
You've been out of order ever since you took them ordination papers.
Jesus. My God. My God.
There's some papers you need to give back.
That's right.
Because of the spirit that's connected to the paper.
Yes.
Ooh, no, let me try.
My God.
That's why sometimes you see people get reaffirmed, reordained.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Because the name on that paper
yes.
represents misery, sorrow,
yes.
and failure.
That's it.
Because the person that did it was not in right standings with God.
That's right.
That's right.
And so you got to disconnect from the spiritual of that
yes.
person.
Yes.
Y'all looking at me crazy?
That's right.
You got to disconnect. So I don't need your name on my credentials.
Abba.
Because your name only carries weight in hell.
Jesus.
Only person recognize you right now is the enemy.
That's right.
God not recognizing you because you're walking in sin.
That's right.
I believe at this moment.
Yes.
Oh, right. So when people see the name that signs your paperwork, they automatically assume you walk in the same spirit.
That's right.
Yes. That, y'all look at
that's
me.
Right. Yes. And it disqualifies.
And it disqualifies
yes.
what you are called to be. Come on now. Hallelujah. Because many times,
yes.
because they are crook anyway,
anyway.
They ordained yes. you in the role of science.
That's right. Yeah. That's right.
And so you got to be real earned, real yes. name, real licensed.
Yes.
Yes.
My God.
You're right.
My God.
Yes. Come on.
Because what they say is not necessarily true.
That's right.
And then sometimes it might be true, but the wrong name on it.
That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right.
So we got to get in a position now, people of God, and get beyond hallelujah, our pride. Sometimes you just got to say, listen, man, woman of God, I know I've been affirmed, but listen.
Yes.
I need to get this covering.
Yes.
Out and over my head.
Yes.
Yes.
My God.
Let me
my God.
Yes. Let me strive. Hallelujah. And there's nothing wrong with that.
Mm.
Come on now. Hallelujah. There's nothing wrong with that.
Yes.
There's nothing wrong with that. You still who you are.
That's right.
But according to the laws of the land. Because some of these preachers been in jail and
Jesus.
My God.
They see their name on your paperwork, they looking at you like the crook they are.
That's right.
Come on. Hallelujah. Right. So you gotta understand, you do need the papers, but you don't want people associating you
yes.
with the person that's yes. on that paper. If that person is not in right standing,
yes.
talking disorderly and
yes.
sin and
yes.
practicing all manner of evil.
Yes, yes.
You're right.
Because that is ushered on your ministry.
Yes.
And the Lord began to deal with me about spiritual lineage. He said, just like naturally,
yes.
the lineage of your line, your bloodline.
That's
he
right.
said, your spiritual bloodline carry the same weight.
Same way.
Yes.
Come on.
Same.
So you got to know what's going on.
Yes.
But I dare you to tell God, yes, for real tonight.
Yes. Yes.
And let God do it. You know what I told God not too long ago? I said, I need you to reanoint me, rededicate me, recommit me. Come on now.
God.
I said, I need you to do a whole new overall
yes.
Come on now. Hallelujah. Because there were some people I connected to that I shouldn't have connected to. But
my
me
God.
Being a person, I'm going to help everybody.
Yes.
But you can't help everybody.
Not everybody.
Hallelujah. Look at somebody and tell them, in this hour.
I'm
becoming brand new.
I'm becoming brand new.
Does anybody else want to be brand new with me tonight?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. That young man sits right back there in the black.
Hallelujah.
You. God, get ready to do a special work.
You have just finished listening to the media ministry of Apostle Barbara R. Thomas. You may write her at Apostle Barbara R. Thomas, P.O. Box 13291, Durham, North Carolina 27709. Thank you for supporting the ministry.